Mr. Pop.
Town where criminals roam the streets. One man is on the case. Brought to you by Bright White Toothpaste and Seymour's Soda Pop. It's The Adventures of Thomas Connelly, starring Thomas Connelly. On this week's episode, our hero finds himself in quite the bind. It all started one dark night when...
That what they're saying about me, huh? Hero. Ain't that a laugh? Of course, I remember it a bit differently. I suppose you'll be wanting to hear my side of it all, huh? That's why you're here, isn't it? Look, if you're jonesing for one of those feel-good, hero-saves-the-day kind of stories, well, then I suggest you just go ahead and give a listen to that radio there. But if you want the truth of it all, yeah, I'll tell it to you. I'll tell it all. The good and the not so good. My story begins with a drink. The Fox and Goose, a regular late-night hang for the guys at the station. Marty, the owner, was just about the nicest guy you'd ever meet. Not to mention he made a mean Manhattan.
Hey, Tom.
Evening, Marty.
Hey, Tom! Tommy! Over here!
Joe Burke flagged me down from across the bar. Joe was just about the best damn agent you ever saw. He was a hothead. The kind of guy to shoot first and ask questions later. Andy was my closest friend.
Hey, Tom. Hey, what took you so long, huh?
Sorry to keep you, Joe. I was taking another look at the Jackson case.
Oh, yeah. That's the double homicide in Trenton, right?
Something just ain't right about it, Joe. I mean, two guys turn up dead under a bridge out of the blue. One of them a cop. No prior convictions, no shady connections.
Hey, let's leave the work at work, huh? Trenton ain't going nowhere. Buy you a beer?
Yeah, sure, Joe. Sure. Sorry.
Tommy. All you do is work. You gotta take it easy. Relax. Hey, Marty, two beers over here.
Two beers. You got it, Joe.
Say, you coming to Jerry's going away party?
Oh, right. I don't know. I really should work on this.
Well, Tommy, I'm not going without you. I can't stand to be around that guy for more than about 5 seconds.
Two beers?
Thanks, Marty. If I have to hear about that goddamn Studebaker one more time...
All right, all right.
Joe, have you seen the new Studebaker? There just ain't another car like it.
All right, now...
There just ain't another car like it.
All right, I said... Give it a rest, will you? Jeez.
So you'll be there?
Yeah, I'll be there.
Glad to hear it.
Hey, to Jerry.
And his goddamn Studebaker.
And his goddamn Studebaker. Hey, Marty. I think we're gonna need another round over here.
Everybody on the ground.
You heard the man.
Get on your knees.
On the ground.
Everybody.
The boss is coming.
Shh. It's the boss. It's the boss.
Everybody shut up.
Quinn. Turn off whatever crap this is and put on something nice. That's more like it. All right, listen up, everybody. I'm gonna need you to empty out your pockets. I said, empty them.
You heard the man.
Hiya, Marty. How's business this evening?
Croft. Son of a bitch.
Shit, Tom, shit. What do we do?
Shut up. Just shut up.
Oh, come on, Marty. That's no way to treat an old friend. You didn't answer my question.
We had a deal.
Are you daft, man? He asked you a goddamn question.
Listen, Mart, sometimes deals change, all right? Like, let's say, for example, that I made a deal with a certain barkeep that I would leave his bar alone because his cousin happens to be an upstanding guy and did me a very big favor once upon a time. Well, now that would seem to be a pretty nice arrangement now, wouldn't it?
I don't know what you are...
Except the certain barkeep didn't happen to mention that his cousin was a cop. Well, needless to say, that would alter the terms of the deal severely. So, you see, Marty, that's why your lying son of a bitch of a cousin and his scheming amigo are now dead under a bridge in Trenton. Now, how do you think the rest of this evening plays out, Mart?
You son of a bitch. I'll kill you for this, Croft.
Clearly, you don't know how this evening plays out.
Tom, we gotta do something now.
Hey! Whoever's talking over there is a dead man.
FBI, put your hands in the air!
Oh, the boys in blue, this is quite the turn of events. Thought you could pull the wool over my eyes? Now, Marty?
I said put him up!
Go to hell.
Drop the gun!
Right after you, Mart.
Oh my god, Marty, you son of a...
The feds! Cocktail boys, come on, let's go!
The feds! They're here! Come on, let's go!
Son of a bitch!
They're getting away!
Leave them, Joe!
But Marty, that bastard!
I said leave them!
Police!
Don't put hands up!
Put your hands in here!
Nobody move!
Whoa, Wilson! Wilson, it's me!
Tom! Joe, what the hell happened?
I'll explain it in a second, Wilson, but you gotta get after those—
Our guys are on their tail as we speak. It's all right, everyone. You're safe. If you could all just stick around for a few minutes, we're gonna grab some statements. Thanks for your cooperation. We'll get you home soon. What happened? You guys all right?
We're fine. Six or seven guys, gangsters by the look of them, tried to rob the place.
Marty's dead.
Jesus Christ.
Some guy named Croft. Big guy, pinstripe suit. There was an Irishman with him too.
Wait, did you say Croft? Michael Croft?
Didn't catch a first name.
Irishman. That'll be Quinn O'Grady. It's Croft, all right.
Bring me up to speed. Michael Croft?
Just about one of the biggest gangsters in all of New Jersey. Practically runs the entire criminal underground. We've been looking for him for years.
There's something else. The double homicide in Trenton? I think we got our guy.
Wilson had the look of someone who'd just been handed a 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle with a couple of the pieces gone. I watched as she struggled to put it all together.
Meet me at the station in half an hour.
Before I left, I made sure to pay my respects to Marty. I was sure gonna miss the good times, the conversations, and the Manhattans. Nobody ever made him quite like Mart.
Hello? Yes.
The station. A place where guys like me thought they had it all figured out. Life was black and white. In my world, there were two kinds of people. The ones who stayed put in their proper place, and the criminals.
Yes, thank you. Good night.
Wilson had called Joe and I into her office to discuss a matter of utmost importance regarding a certain Frenchman and an old flame.
So this Frenchman, what was his name again?
Leblanc. Gaston Leblanc.
So we're gonna meet this Leblanc and...
Not you, Joe. We need you here. You and Thomas were the only agents that were the Fox and Goose. You got a good look at him. Tom will go and meet Leblanc.
How did you find this guy?
He's one of Croft's guys. We picked him up running guns out of Schenectady. He agreed to give us everything he has on Croft, and we agreed to give him 5 years instead of the chair.
I see, but I never work alone, Wilson. I need Joe out in the field.
Who said anything about you working alone? Rest assured, you'll be working with one of the best.
Who?
Her name is Agent Lockhart. Comes highly recommended from Los Angeles.
Lockhart? Lana Lockhart?
You know her?
Yeah, I know her.
Oh, so it's like that, huh, Tom?
Yeah, and maybe it was like that at one time, but now we're just old acquaintances. It'll be nice to see her again.
Listen, maybe it would be better if we found someone else and...
Wilson, give me the details.
You and Lana will meet up with LeBlanc at the Hotshot Club. LeBlanc is meeting Croft there to discuss some kind of business. You and Lana will keep an eye on them both, learn anything you can, and report back. Everything clear?
This stinks. Sitting around in a desk and chair with that bastard's out there dancing and sipping on cocktails.
I don't like it any more than you do, Joe. Sounds like an awful risk to me.
Trust me on this one, Tom. If things go wrong, even if you get a bad feeling, you get out of there. Understood?
Yeah, understood.
Good luck.
As I left the station, I couldn't help thinking that this was turning out to be the longest night of my life. I had no idea. The Hotshot Club, a favorite destination for the kind of guy whose morals were questionable on a good day. I stood at the entrance for a good moment to take it all in. And then I saw her, standing just a few feet away from me. Lana. I always wondered how I'd feel if I ever ran into her again. Seeing her standing there in the middle of the club in that long white dress was the craziest thing. I suddenly felt as if time stood still and we were the only two people that existed. After a moment, I shook myself out of it and I walked on over to her. Come here often?
Tom!
You seem surprised to see me.
You're late.
Can you believe that? 3 years I haven't seen this woman, and all she says is you're late.
Were you expecting a warm welcome?
After 3 years? No. No, you're right. Crazy of me to expect something along the lines of, say, a simple hello.
How has New York been treating you? I wouldn't know since I haven't received any calls or even a letter since you left.
I'm sorry, I'm forgetting exactly who it was that ended it between us. Can you refresh my memory?
Hello, Tom.
Hello, Lana.
Happy?
Very.
Good. Now that that's out of the way, let's talk strategy. How many guards did you see?
Two at the front door, two in the back of the club near the bar, and another three next to the stage. Any sign of LeBlanc?
He'll be along, arriving with Croft any minute now.
Oh, Jimmy, how's your wife doing?
That's him now.
Croft made his way to a booth in the back with who I assumed to be LeBlanc and a few of his cronies. Lana and I moved to the back of the club and sat discreetly at a table near Croft and his company. He was in good spirits. He clearly had more than a few, which made it easy for me to hear every word of the conversation.
So I says to him, gun to his face, I swear to God, I says, clearly you don't see how this evening plays out. And he looks at me, right at me, and he says, I kid you not, he says, go to hell, Croft. So I look him dead in the eye and say, right after you, Mott. And then I shoot him right between his goddamn eyes. He just spilled out. Hey, bartender, another round over here, and then make it snappy, will you?
Yeah, give me a bite.
Speaking of guns, LeBlanc, come here. How's my latest shipment?
It is right on schedule. The boat arrives tomorrow.
Glad to hear it, my friend. Glad to hear it. Now, LeBlanc, when I pick up the shipment...
Mikey, I want to go dancing.
Yeah, okay. In a minute, though, all right? In a minute. Jesus. Now, as I was saying...
But they're playing my song.
Honey, this is a business meeting. You hear? It is a meeting where we discuss business.
You promise.
And sweetie, I'll make good on it. Just as soon as I get back to...
Oh, it's fine. I'll just go dancing by myself, I guess. Maybe find myself a nice Joe at the bar to join me.
Gwen! Come here! Would you kindly escort my dearest to the bar and get her another drink? Keep a close eye on her. I'll meet her there soon enough.
Come along, kitty.
I can find my own way, thank you very much.
Lovely girl.
Ungrateful broad. So, tomorrow then, we're all set?
Tomorrow.
How many crates?
17.
LeBlanc, you're an artist.
The docks, 10 p.m. I'll meet you there.
Glad to hear it! I'll see you there. Oh, bartender!
Croft and LeBlanc stood up and began walking in our direction.
They're heading this way. Quick, dance with me.
Before I could stop and think, Lana had grabbed my arm and led me to the floor. Croft walked past us and made his way to the door.
All right, come on. Kitty, we're leaving.
Now wait just a minute. You promised.
Yeah, well,
I haven't even finished my drink yet.
Well, that's going to be the least of your problems, Kitty, because if you ain't out that door in 5 seconds, I'll give you 2 black eyes, so help me.
Well, I never in all my life.
That's more like it.
Just who do you think you are, mister?
I'm sorry, baby. You know I didn't mean it.
Whew, they're gone.
So they are.
So where's LeBlanc?
He'll meet up with us later. Give Croft some time to clear out.
Did you catch all that about the docks?
Sure did. Shipment of guns.
Yeah, that'll be enough to put Croft away for good.
So it will.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. That was a lighter shade of blue. Let's hear it for that hot cha band. We're almost done for the night, but here's one more to send you on your way. A one, a two, a one, two, three, four.
What are the odds?
Of all the songs in the world, huh?
God, it's been so long since I've heard it.
Yeah, I think the last time was...
At the orchard. On the rooftop.
We danced the night away.
That's right.
God, it seems like a lifetime ago. How did this song go again? Fate. Can't you see that it's fate?
goes to show when the chips fall down, it's not too late to follow our heart and call upon.
Say, Lana, I...
Thank you so much.
I'm gonna scope out the place, get a better look near the bar.
I'll mingle with the locals, see if I can learn anything.
Hey, you want a drink? Gin martini, right?
Yes.
I was making my way across the club to the bar when all of a sudden...
Hey!
Ooh, sorry, mister, my apologies.
Don't worry about it. Hey, don't I know you from somewhere? Marlowe's! Bingo on Mondays, isn't it?
No, I don't think that...
No, that's not it. Don't you work at the flower shop down the street? Harry's?
No, I don't think that...
Wait a minute. I know. I've shot at you before, haven't I?
My heart was racing a million miles per hour as I moved my hand slowly to the .45 in my jacket pocket. I waited for Quinn to make a move.
I'm playing with ya, boy! Of course it must have been Marlowe's. I'll see ya Monday then, eh?
Yeah, sure.
Well, good night to ya.
After I made damn sure Quinn had left through the front door, I raced back to Lana. Hey, listen, we gotta get out of here fast.
Why? What happened?
I just bumped into Quinn O'Grady, Croft's right-hand man. He must have stuck around after Croft split.
Did he recognize you?
I got the feeling he might have, but I'm not taking any chances.
Let's get out of here.
Lana and I had barely gotten out the front door when a stranger in a long coat beckoned us over. The hat he wore concealed his face. My hand went again to the .45.
Psst! Jesus, LeBlanc! Where have you been?
So you're the famous LeBlanc I've heard so much about.
And you must be Thomas Connelly. It is a pleasure to finally meet you.
Let's skip with the pleasantries, LeBlanc. Keep your hands where I can see them.
I can assure you that I am-
Hands out of your pockets, I said.
I can assure you I am unarmed.
Alright, spill. What's the deal with Croft?
The docks tomorrow night, right? When?
10 o'clock. 17 cases of guns. If the FBI wants Croft, that's how you're going to get him.
Yeah? That's how it's going down, is it?
We heard it from Croft himself, Tom. Why don't you take it easy?
Sorry, I just have a hard time taking the word of a criminal.
How about the word of a man who is trying to save his own skin, huh?
I don't like this any more than you do, Tom. But Croft has no idea we have LeBlanc. What reason would we have to lie to him?
Do not take my word for it. Bring your men tomorrow and see it for yourself. If I am wrong, then do with me as you wish.
Alright, LeBlanc. Tomorrow.
10 o'clock.
We'll be there.
Lana and I left LeBlanc at the street corner. I watched him carefully as he walked away into the night. Maybe this Frenchman was the key to Croft after all.
I'll see you tomorrow at the station, first thing in the morning.
Yeah.
Listen, despite our past, it's good to be working with you again. And it's good to see you. Good night, Tom.
Good night, Lana. I stood on the sidewalk and watched as she drove away. After a moment, I started down the street towards my car. After a minute or two, for a reason I couldn't explain, I began to feel uneasy. Like I was being watched. I quickened my pace. I saw my car in front of me. Suddenly I heard a rustle behind me. I turned around just in time to see a dark figure and the fist that went along with it. The last thing I remember is my face hitting the concrete. The rest is darkness.
Today's episode of The Adventures of Thomas Connelly is brought to you by Bright White Toothpaste.
I use Bright White twice a day for a glistening smile.
Just brush twice a day and you'll be the talk of the town.
Bright White is a hit with the ladies.
You can't go wrong with Bright White, official sponsor of The Adventures of Thomas Connelly. Available today in...
I never liked this stuff. Left a bad taste in my mouth. Anyway, where were we? Oh, yeah. I was out cold. I awoke slowly and painfully, with a ringing in my ears. I was sitting down and my hands were tied behind my back. When the world finally came into focus, I found I was looking at a man. One I'd seen just moments before at the club.
Well, well, well. Welcome back to the world.
Quinn.
So you do recognize me after all. And not from Marlos, as it turns out.
What do you want from me?
Well, it's not so much what I want.
Listen, cut the riddles, will ya, and give it to me straight.
Last I checked, I am the one making the rules around here. And you do best to cooperate with them.
Alright, Quinn. What do you want?
Didn't you hear what I said? And here he is now. Evening, boss. Allow me to introduce you to FBI agent Thomas Connelly.
FBI, you said? What was that name again? Thomas?
Connelly. Says so right on the badge you got there.
Right, right. The badge. Which brings me to why I'm here. Let me ask you something. What were you doing at the Hot Chuck Club tonight?
Enjoying the music. And a Manhattan.
Sounds beautiful. Listen, Connelly. There's two ways that we can go about this. The easy way, or the hard way.
What do you want?
What's the FBI got on me?
Two murders up in Trenton.
I see. Anything else?
Ain't that enough?
Let me rephrase the question. Give me everything the FBI has on me, or I will personally blow your goddamn brains out like I did your friend at the Fox and Goose.
The shipment of guns, tomorrow. The docks, 10 o'clock.
There it is! Now that wasn't so hard, was it?
So how about it? Am I free to go?
Are you free to go? Well, unfortunately, I can't have you running back to your FBI friends to tell them everything that happened here tonight. So, I'm afraid this evening does not end so well for you.
Attends, just a minute, Croft.
Leblanc! I didn't know you'd stuck around.
What is happening here?
Well, you see, I've run into a bit of trouble with the FBI. So I'm tying up a few loose ends.
Oh, so you're just going to shoot him right here on the street, huh?
Yeah. That's the plan.
Mais non, people will hear. No, no, no. Let me handle the man.
I knew it, you two-timing snake.
Oh, shut up!
I'll take him to the docks. You know, you just give me 1 hour with him, and I guarantee you, he will tell you anything you want to know.
All right, Leblanc. He's all yours. Don't leave a mess.
Don't I have a say in the matter?
You shut up! Get in the car.
I knew you were trouble from the start, you lying son of a...
We're getting out of here.
What?
I said we're getting out of here. Now, you may want to hold on to something.
What are you...
What the hell? God damn it, they're getting away! Get after them!
You hold the man!
Hold that car!
Gotta admit, Leblanc, I thought I had you pegged.
At least now you know where my loyalties lie, huh?
Listen, if you don't mind, I'd love some help with these binds. My wrists are killing me.
Hold still. There you go.
Thanks.
How's the head?
I'll be fine. Think we lost him?
Ah, merde! Take the wheel. Putain. I'll hold them off. You try and get them off our tail.
You sons of bitches!
All right, I'm gonna try something. Hold on tight! Damn, these guys are persistent.
Nah, we'll get rid of them. You head towards the railroad.
Railroad, got it. Ah, God damn it, headlights are out, I can't see a thing. You're gonna have to be my eyes, Leblanc.
Tourne à gauche au prochain feu, là. Non, tourne à gauche, tourne à gauche.
God damn it, English, Leblanc.
Left!
Did we lose him? Whew. I don't see him.
I think we lost him.
Whew, thank God.
Oh, la 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 la. Okay. So where to?
Back to my car. I've had enough excitement tonight to last a month.
Of course.
Hey, listen, thanks back there. You really saved my neck. Listen, what I'm trying to say is that I was wrong about you, and I'm sorry that I...
Listen to me. I have done a lot of things I am not proud of. In France, I had nothing. Then I came to America and I had nothing. Croft, he gave me a chance to create a life for myself. I mean, a chance to really live, you know? I've done things I never thought I would ever do. Things I am not proud of. But perhaps this is my chance to make it right.
Perhaps you're right, Leblanc. Anyway, we're glad to have you.
Oh, I almost forgot. Hit me.
What?
Hit me. It needs to look like you overpowered me. I'll say you took control of the car and then threw me out on the street. Well, what are you waiting for?
Okay. Sorry about this.
That was a good one.
I drove myself back to my car, and Leblanc and I went our separate ways. The night was finally at an end. Well, as you've probably guessed, the docks turned out to be a bust. Croft was spooked after last night. Half the FBI turned up to try and bag him, but he and those 17 crates full of guns never showed. The next couple of weeks had a similar theme. Lana and I followed every clue, every whisper of the name Croft. But all of them turned out to be dead ends. My clumsiness that night at the club had cost us more than I thought. Fast forward another week or so to a going-away party. Everyone was in good spirits. A welcome change after the string of letdowns.
Joe, I'm telling you, the new Studebaker is simply the best there is. There just ain't another car like it.
Yeah, Jerry, that's fascinating, really.
There just ain't another car like it.
Mm-hmm. You hear that, Tom? Tom?
Hmm? Oh, yeah. No, that's swell, Jerry. Just swell. Excuse me, William.
Wait a minute. Tom, where are you going?
I need a smoke.
Tom, don't leave me here. Tom!
Now, Joe. Have I told you about the leather interior, Joe?
Only 14 times, Jerry.
Oh, Joe. I simply must show you, Joe. Now, Joe, the thing with the all-leather interior, Joe, is that you really gotta get in...
See, that was the thing with me back then. If there was a case left unsolved, that was all that was on my mind. No amount of parties, drinks, or anything could change that. Or so I thought.
Mind if I join you? Got one of those for me?
Sure.
Cool night tonight.
Yeah.
Fresh air.
Hmm.
Everything all right?
Right as rain.
Enjoying the party?
Oh, it's great. Gonna miss Jerry.
No, you're not.
And how do you know? You just met the guy.
If I have to sit through one more conversation about that car of his...
Yeah, he got to you too, huh?
It's like a love affair with that car.
Is that why you came out here, huh? To escape?
Well, how about you?
Well, me? I'm having a smoke before I see the car.
You just ain't seen nothing like it.
It's funny.
What?
You and me, here, together on this case.
Yeah, life's funny that way. How's LA been treating you?
It's fine. It's good. I'm happy.
Yeah, I bet it's nice out there.
It's different. A lot of things are different.
Weather and all.
Lots of changes.
Changes, huh? I'll tell you, you haven't changed a bit. Hey, listen, Lana, I want you to know that that day, 3 years ago, the day that you left me,
I'm engaged.
What's his name?
Roger.
Roger.
He's a doctor.
Roger the doctor.
Tom.
And he's a good guy, huh? You're happy?
Yes, he is. He's wonderful, and we're very happy.
Well, then I'm happy for you. Really, I am.
Thank you. Tom, I want you to know that I...
Tom. Sorry, Tom, but Wilson says she's got to see you right away.
What's the news, Joe?
I think you're going to like it.
I made my way to Wilson's office. She explained that apparently one of her guys had been eating at a local diner where one of the waitresses fit the description of Croft's new girl.
Kitty, right? That was her name?
Kitty by night, Katherine Parker by day. She's our way in.
What on earth is a waitress doing with Michael Croft?
There's obviously more to all of this. You and Tom will go down to that diner and see what you can learn.
So Lana and I made our way down to the diner the following afternoon. It was a seedy little place. The kind you'd only pass through for a quick cup of joe and a 5-cent bagel on your way to work.
Hello. Welcome to Rusty's Diner. Can I get you a coffee?
No, thank you. I'm looking for a girl who works here. Parker? Katherine Parker?
She's here. Stepped out back for a cig. Want me to get her for you?
Oh, that won't be necessary. I'll go out and meet her. I'm her uncle, you see?
Don't remember Kathy saying anything about an uncle in town.
Oh, yes, she's not expecting us, actually. We thought we'd drop in and surprise her here at work. Isn't that right, honey?
Oh, yes, that's right, darling. Mind if we step out back? We're just dying to see her.
Okay. You can follow me.
Oh, no need. I'm sure you're busy. We'll find her on our own. Thanks so much, honey.
So Lana and I did our best to evade the skeptical stares darting at us from the waitress. Eventually, we made our way to the back of the diner, opened up the door, and found ourselves in an alleyway. Sure enough, there, leaning up against a wall smoking a cigarette, was...
Kitty.
Yeah?
Katherine Parker.
Who are you?
I'm Agent Thomas Connelly, and this is Agent Lana Lockhart. We need to ask you a few questions.
You cops?
FBI. We just have a couple of questions that we need to...
I ain't talking to no cops or FBI or whoever you are. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have to get back to work.
Katherine.
That ain't my goddamn name. Now, if you'll excuse me...
Listen, Kitty. Either you answer our questions now, or we'll take you down to the station, and then you'll answer our questions. Which will it be?
What do you want with me? I ain't done nothing wrong.
3 weeks ago, the Hot Shot Club. Michael Croft. Ring any bells?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Damn it, Kitty. I was there. I saw you. Now you better cut the bull and start cooperating with us if you ever want to serve another mediocre cup of coffee again.
I can't.
What do you mean, you can't?
He'll kill me if he knew.
Kitty, give us what we want, and you have my word that Croft will never lay a finger on you.
You don't understand. He'll find a way. He always finds a way. Once he's done with me, he'll come for you. You don't stand a chance.
He'll never know you talk to us. If you give us what we want, we'll leave right now. I promise. Now just tell us where he is.
I don't know.
Sure you do.
I said I don't know. He don't tell me nothing.
Can you tell us anything at all?
There's a poker game.
Poker game?
Tonight. At the Altman Garage. You know where that is?
I know where it is. Croft will be there?
Croft don't play poker. Quinn will be there. Quinn O'Grady plays every Thursday. You get Quinn, you get Croft. Can I go now?
Yes, Kitty, you can go.
Kitty hurried back into the restaurant. Cut to later that night. The Altman garage. We had the perfect plan. Joe, Lana, and I would wait outside with the rest of the squad while Leblanc dealt himself into the game on a false invitation from Croft. At some point in the game, Leblanc would find some excuse to leave the room and cut the lights. Then we'd make our move. Our only hope was that Quinn wouldn't catch wise.
Now, remember, huh? You wait here until I cut the power, not a moment sooner. If it goes south, you get out of here, understood?
Understood, but nothing's going south, though. You hear? This is foolproof. Croft is as good as ours after this.
At that moment, a couple of cars drove up to the garage. About a dozen men got out and headed inside. They were hard to discern in the shadows of the night, but the Irishman I recognized immediately.
There's Quinn. Good luck, Leblanc.
Leblanc walked up to the door, knocked, and all of us held our breath.
What in the bloody hell are you doing here?
Hey, easy, Quinn, easy. How about lowering the gun, huh? It's making me uncomfortable.
Shut up and answer the question. How did you know I was here?
Why the hell do you think, huh?
Croft sent you, did he? Why?
He wanted to try his hand at the game.
Then why the hell isn't he here telling me this?
Well, I don't know, Quinn. Usually when he tells me to do something, I don't ask questions. Why don't you call him up and ask him?
Maybe I'll do exactly that.
Sure, do it. I don't care. I mean, we both know he's seeing a show tonight. So why don't you go right ahead and call him in the middle of it to ask him why he isn't playing poker with you?
The game is 5-card stud.
My favorite.
Leblanc was in. Now the only thing left to do was wait. Do you mind cutting that out?
What's taking him so long?
It's only been an hour, Joe.
All I'm saying is it's been a while. What if something happened?
We would have heard something. Everything's fine.
I say we just storm the place.
No, we wait for the signal. Stick to the plan.
Okay. Or we screw the plan.
Leblanc will come through.
We gotta get in there now.
God damn it, Joe, will you shut up?
Hey, the lights.
They're off.
That's our cue. Let's go.
We took off towards the garage. Joe kicked in the door and we rushed in, guns raised.
FBI, get your hands in the air.
Nobody moves.
Hey, we got a runner.
It's Quinn. Hey, stop.
Get after him. I'll hold it down here.
Lana and I darted out the back door and chased after Quinn. He was quick, but eventually we caught up with him.
Hold it, Quinn. That alley's a dead end. There's nowhere left to run.
Put the gun down.
You'll have to kill me first, you sons of bitches.
We don't want to kill you, Quinn. Just put the gun down and we'll talk.
Shove it up your arse.
Where's Croft, you son of a bitch?
She's feisty, that one. I like that.
I'm not going to ask you again. Put the gun down, or so help me, I'll...
You'll what? Shoot me? You need me, Connelly.
It's your move, Quinn.
I want a full pardon.
Come again?
You heard me. I want my record wiped. Clean slate.
That can be arranged, if you help us. What can you give us on Croft?
Everything.
Okay, just put the gun down and we'll...
And I want a ticket back to Ireland. First thing tomorrow. No police, no FBI, just me.
Done. Do we have a deal?
We have a deal.
Good. Now where's Croft?
I'm not saying a word until I see that ticket.
Now listen, Quinn.
I ain't saying a goddamn word until I see...
Quinn was cut short by a poisoned dart to the neck. Lana and I turned around, guns raised, but there was no one there. Only the darkness of the alleyway. Quinn's eyes widened in disbelief. He took one step forward, and then he dropped his gun and fell to his knees. I rushed to him and caught him right before he fell to the ground.
Quinn, talk to me. Where's Croft?
Where is he, goddammit?
Cleo. Cleopatra.
What did he say?
Cleopatra.
Who's Cleopatra?
I have no idea.
This episode is brought to you by Seymour's Soda Pop, the official soda pop of crime fighters everywhere.
Hello, I'm Seymour, proud owner of Seymour Soda Pop.
And I'm Agent Thomas Connelly.
Seymour's is proud to be the go-to drink of the FBI. Ain't that right, Thomas?
You said it, Seymour. When I'm on the case, I always make certain I have an ice-cold bottle of Seymour's handy. That in my trusty 45, of course.
You said it, pal!
So make Seymour's your official choice. Pick it up today at your local...
Seymour died shortly after we did that ad. Diabetes. After all that talk of fighting crime, it was the soda pop that did him in. Poor guy. Anyway, speaking of fighting crime, we had found a clue. One word. Cleopatra. Quinn's dying word put us absolutely no closer to finding Croft. And time was running out.
All right, people, what do we have?
I've scanned every record in the state of New Jersey. No leads on any Cleopatra.
Hardly anybody even named Cleopatra. The six girls I found all have spotless records.
Well, find them. Start questioning them.
I'm sorry, you want me to question every girl?
You got a better idea? We're running out of time. Any minute now, Croft will hear about what happened at the garage, and when he hears about it, we'll never see him again. I guarantee it.
Perhaps it's easier than we think. What if he's talking about the actual Cleopatra?
As in, Cleopatra, the ruler of ancient Egypt? Why the hell would Croft care about ancient history?
I don't know, maybe it's a code. What if he is hiding something in Egypt?
Leblanc, have you lost your mind?
Well, unless you have a better idea.
Ancient Egypt, craziest thing I've ever...
Better than questioning random women with spotless records.
Ah, voilà, I agree. Do you know how long it will take to question every single Cleopatra in the state of New Jersey?
Long enough for Croft to escape, and this time, for good.
Well, we have to think of something. This ancient Egypt idea is crazy talk.
Well, I don't see you coming up with any bright ideas.
Well, that's exactly what I'm trying to do, not entertain some wild goose chase.
Hey, would you all shut up? I think I got it.
Thank God. What do you have, Joe?
We're so busy talking about this Cleopatra as if it's a person. But what if Cleopatra's not a who, but a what?
Joe.
Okay. Look at this.
Oh my God.
The USS Cleopatra. It's not a person, it's a ship.
The shipment of guns?
Exactly. He's using the Cleopatra to smuggle the guns. And check out the schedule. She's coming in tonight. Tonight.
10:25 p.m. That's in a half hour.
Get down to the docks. He'll have no idea we're coming. We'll catch him completely by surprise.
That son of a bitch is ours.
What are you all still standing here for? Get everyone down to the docks.
The place flew into a frenzy. This was it. The moment we'd all waited for. Croft was as good as ours. We had our target. All that was left was to go and get the bastard. The USS Cleopatra. The final stage. The end game. Our squad pulled up to the boat, sirens off, sounds low. As to not give ourselves away.
Well, this is it?
Hopefully. Getting tired of chasing this bastard around the city.
How could it not be? It makes sense. He has to be here.
Yeah. Think he'll put up a fight?
God, I hope so.
You know, I'm thinking of leaving New York.
You are?
Yeah, thinking this'll be my last case here.
Where will you go?
I don't know, somewhere quieter. Join the local PD, handle small-time stuff. How about you? Any plans after this is done?
Don't know. Roger might have an opportunity up north. Maybe settle down.
Really? Lana Lockhart leave the force?
Maybe.
I never pegged you for the white picket fence type.
Well, maybe I've changed since you and I...
No. No. No, you haven't changed a bit. You might be able to fool your husband-to-be, but you can't fool me. You love this job. More than anything in the world, you love this job. And no amount of picket fences or front lawns or family dinners are gonna change that. You're a cop. It's what you were born to do. It's why you left me here in New York. It's why you're here now. And it's why you're not moving up north with Roger.
Well, it looks like you don't know a single thing about me.
Hey, you guys ready? We're about to move.
Yeah, LeBlanc. Ready.
Lana?
Yeah.
We made our way silently down the dock to the Cleopatra. As we got closer, we slowed our pace and took cover behind some crates near the ramp to the ship.
LeBlanc, you're with me. After we get up the ramp and clear the first group, we'll take four guys and go north. Tom, you and Lana head south with the rest of the squad. Everybody got it?
Got it.
On my signal. One, two, three!
FBI! Everyone get your hands in the...
What the...
Where is everyone?
There's nobody here.
It cannot be.
No.
Search the boat!
You heard the man, search the boat!
There's no one here.
Oh, no, god damn it! This is it, they have to be here!
I don't hear a goddamn thing, Joe, do you?
I don't understand. This had to be it, they had to be here.
Maybe they're hiding. Wait until they search the boat.
Right. Tom, take Lana and search every single plank of this ship.
Hey, Joe! North is clear.
South is clear too, Joe. No one on board but us.
We're too late.
God damn it.
We've lost him. For good.
No. There has to be some other explanation.
No, there is no other explanation. We lost. That's it. Michael Croft is gone.
We were too late. Plain and simple. We figure it out too late.
How far do you think he's gone by now?
By now? Halfway across the world.
Or right under your nose. Don't even think about moving. We got the whole lot of you surrounded. Drop your weapons. I said drop them right now.
Do as he says.
Well. You thought you could outsmart me, huh? Thought you could get the jump on Michael Croft, huh?
You son of a bitch.
Next one that talks, shoot him. Oh, wait. I remember you. Yeah, at the Fox and Goose. You tried to put a bullet in me.
Son of a bitch, you gotta
it looks like tonight they'll get to return the favor. Oh, and FBI agent Thomas Connelly. Nice to see you again. Oh, look who we have here, boys. Gaston Leblanc.
Traitor!
You know where I come from.
There's a special place in hell for rats like you. Oh, and what do we have here? You're a pretty one, aren't you?
Get your goddamn hands off her!
You got a lot of balls for someone in your position, Mr. Connelly. But I admire your courage. I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. First, I'm gonna shoot your pretty little girlfriend. And then, I'll shoot the traitor. And then your friend. And then, I'll shoot you. Any last words, Dom?
Go to hell.
Right after you.
Croft!
Wilson!
What the?
We have you surrounded. Give it up, Croft.
Son of a bitch! Shoot him! Shoot them all! God damn it!
Top! He's getting away!
We can get him, Joe! Lana, come on! Lana!
Tom.
Oh my god, Lana!
Quick! Somebody help her!
No.
She's been shot.
No.
Get a paramedic in here! Tom, you have to stop him.
No, I'm not leaving you.
Tom.
Somebody help her!
Thomas.
Where's that paramedic?
Look at me. I'll be fine. Stop, Croft. Go.
I'll be right back. I'll be right back. Joe!
I'm on it!
Let's go! Joe and I took off down the deck of the Cleopatra, full speed in pursuit of Croft. Croft!
Where did he go?
I don't...
Where did he go, god damn it!
Joe, look out!
Oh!
Joe? Joe, wake up, Joe!
Hello, Agent Connelly! Miss me?
You son of a bitch, I'll kill you!
Just you and me now, Connelly. Come on!
Croft swung at me with a crowbar like a bat out of hell.
Come on!
I dodged the first swing.
Yeah!
Dodged the second.
Yeah!
The third found me right in the rib cage.
Ha!
I bit down on the pain, took advantage of the moment, and landed a blow on his right temple.
Yeah! Yeah!
And again!
Yeah!
I let my guard down. He got me with the back of his hand.
Yeah! Oh!
Put me down on the ground right next to Joe. Right as I tried to get up, the heel of his boot in my face put me back down on the ground.
Time to die now, Connelly.
Croft raised the crowbar over his head to strike the killing blow. In one last effort, I reached my hand over to the gun holstered at Joe's hip. I got a firm grip on the handle. And right as Croft was about to bring down the crowbar to end my life, I pulled the gun out of its holster and...
Thomas, are you alright?
I got a pulse on Joe. Someone help me here!
Is she alright?
Tom.
Is she alright?
The bullet. It.
No.
Thomas!
Tom!
Lana? Lana.
Tom?
Hold on, Lana. You're gonna be okay.
It's going to be all right.
Everything's gonna be...
Shh.
If we could just...
It'll be all right.
We got him, Lana. We got him. We won.
I can hear our song. come. Our song. Remember?
I remember.
Our song. Goes to show when the chips are down, it's not too late
to follow our heart and call upon. Lana? Lana? No. No, 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 Lana. Lana? No. No, no, no. No.
So there's the truth of it all. The adventures of Thomas Connelly. No happily ever afters. No fairy tales. Just the truth. After Lana... After everything that happened... I stopped going to work, eventually lost my badge, and then I just stopped doing anything at all, and now I'm alone with nothing but my drink and my thoughts. Thoughts. Thoughts of the case, how I might have, you know, done things different if I could go back and do it all again. And as I thought more and more about it, the more I began to put the pieces together. You see, the entire time we were always a step behind. No matter what we did, Croft always had the upper hand. Almost as if he knew our every move. Yes, you see, I was blind at the time not to see it, but now I see it clearly. Very clearly. You see, Croft had someone on the inside. A rat. And that brings our little story to the present. To where I am right now. Taking a little trip down memory lane. Waiting in the rat's nest with my whiskey and my 45. Oh, would you look at that? Right on schedule. Hello, Leblanc. No, don't move. Watch those hands. Keep them where I can see them.
Thomas? Thomas, what are you...
I said don't move. Keep your hands up.
Thomas, I don't know what this is, but... Why don't you put the gun down, huh? We'll talk through whatever misunderstanding you...
Misunderstanding. Oh, you always made me laugh, LeBlanc. I'll give you that. Misunderstanding, he says.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about.
Ah, well, that's disappointing. I thought you were smarter than that.
I don't know what you're...
You think I wouldn't figure it out? Huh? You think I was stupid? You thought you were so goddamn smart, didn't you? How'd you get away?
What?
The night at the garage. How'd you slip away long enough to kill Quinn with the poison dart?
I didn't kill Quinn.
Interesting choice of poison. Very rare, but probably not too hard for you to come by, seeing how it's only manufactured in France.
Thomas, please, just put the gun down, okay? I don't know what this is, but...
The poison, LeBlanc! I know everything, you son of a bitch. You were with Croft from the start, you two-faced snake.
Thomas.
The Hotcha Club, the garage, the Cleopatra, all lies.
Listen to me.
You filthy fucking rat. You traitor. She died because of you. Because of you.
Thomas, listen. Just listen to me, okay? Just give me a chance to explain myself. Please, just... There's something you need to see. I'm going to take something out of my pocket now, okay? Just this... There's just something I need to show you.
Hey, I said keep your hands where I can... You... Goddamn... Rat! You...
Je suis navré. Y'a rien de personnel. Que du business.
And that concludes our epic tale for this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Be sure to tune in next week for another exciting adventure. Till next time, like Thomas Connelly, remember to always carry that fighting spirit and desire for justice within your hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, good night, and thank you for listening.